How's your day going?
Gotta run back and
forth. Yeah?
What about you?
It's going good.
Yeah?
It's tamer than I thought it would be.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm kind of chill. Maybe that's New York.
I mean, it's a different vibe than it's in New
York. Very different.
Oh, yeah. So I have to ask, who's your favorite Batman?
My favorite Batman has to be Christian Bale.
Good choice.
He brought a real darkness to that character that I feel like we hadn't seen before. Mm-hmm. He was good.
And this is a little fun question for you. If you had to choose any of the titles to fight by your side,
I choose Hawkman. Yeah, because they've been fighting together for so long, and they have that history in common. They know how each other moves. They're a good team together. So I would have to say Hawkman. No cipher. No monsters. No fireballs. Just
as human as it
just
gets.
Just good heart to heart. Yeah, hand to hand.
So how kind of went into figuring out what you were going to bring to playing Robin. You know, we have this kind of side of the character we've never really seen before in the movies. And even Teen Titans, like the animated shows, like it's a little bit lighter, but here, like, he's obviously not very happy with Batman at all. Like, and it's something we haven't really seen before.
Yeah, I think it's the relationship is very much like a father who loves his son but mistreated him by not giving him the things that, you know, kind of that that relationship where underneath it all is love. You know, they Batman and Robin, Bruce and Dick, they love each other, and Bruce took on Dick as a young boy when he had no, you know, his parents were murdered and he was kind of lost and scared, and you know, I feel like underneath it all is this thank you and this love for protecting me, but also resentment for turning him into a weapon, you know, and maybe teaching him the things that are not that great.
We have time for one last question. What would you do being your boss?
I think it was the ideas behind the tone of the show. The director of the first two episodes and executive producer Brad Anson had a lot to do with it. I saw it being very, very similar to The Machinist. You know, and I thought that style of shooting a movie, you know, with comic book characters could be really interesting. And that mixed with Akiva Goldsman and Jeff Johns' ideas of how they're going to write the show and what they wanted for it and how they wanted to delve into the backstories of these guys, I felt something that I could offer to the table, you know? The light, comedic, superhero, aggressive, kind of funny movie way of shooting these shows, I don't know how to do that, you know. But the more intimate kind of backstory, you know, drama, slower stories, I could do that. I hope.
No, she's right. All right, I'm gonna grab.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.